Welcome back to PJ Chen Design. Today we are going to talk about the structure and how to model for this Byzantine style chain. Are you ready? Let's get started. For this style of a chain, the model is actually not difficult at all, but it's the calculation on the structure. So let's study the structure first. Right here, we want to have some space. You don't want them to get it too tight. So if you get this chain really tight over there, you probably don't have a room for it to rotate it. So when the chain is actually rotated, you need to have some room for it. Otherwise, it's kind of bumping into each other. You also need to consider how much of a rotation you have. Then if you doesn't have this opening enough, that might blocking it. So we can see this will have room maybe from here to here, right? And also this one will have room to go in and out. But whatever you are doing, just using the middle line as a calculation. So make sure that you have enough space for them to moving around. We're going to starting with the top view. I'm going to use the conic corner for rectangle, and you can draw anywhere for any size that you want first, coming back something like that. And I would like to align to the center, just type it 0, and we can move it to anywhere that we want. The second thing I'm going to do is creating a profile there. Or the cross sections. I'm gonna use a conic corner again, and I'm going to snapping over there. Depends on how big your stone, or if you are going to set the stone there, or whatever size of the thickness on this link over here. And let's go ahead to move this one up. All right, and then if you feel this is too fat or something, we can change it later, but let's keep it like that first. We wanted to have the sweep one rail to get this one down. It looked a little bit fat, but that's okay. We are going to change it later. We're just gonna use it as a reference to see the measurement for everything, see if that is working correctly. The second thing that I like to do is using the ellipse tool and snapping into the 0 and kind of get an idea of where that piece in the center is going to be. And again, I may want to just using this one, and let's copy that. So we kind of keep the same profile into here. And again, we want to do a test to see if size fit. So let's do the sweep one rail and kind of getting the shape over here. Okay, so it look okay because it's not over half of this link right there, but apparently it's a little bit too fast. So maybe we need to have them going down a little bit like that. All right, and don't worry about the shape, but deformant, we're gonna redo it again here just for us to measure everything. All right, imagine if I have this mirror to the other side, and I will have something like that, and this will be where in the middle that link it's going to be. If you feel like this is too much of a gap, this is a good opportunity, and now we wanted to moving a little bit. Okay, and you also need to make sure that has enough space for the two bar to working in between. If you feel like that's not enough space and you probably don't want to move this in, instead you want to extend it something like that. That may be a better space over there. Okay, so now let's do mirror to the other side one more time, and we wanted to have that over here. Okay, so now we are going to making the bar in the middle. We're going to use the conic corner one more time, and we want to center and snapping into the 0, and that's coming into the front view. We want something that is can go over to the inside of the link on both end, right? And I'm gonna come in down something like that. So this will be the curve that we have. We're gonna use the same profile. Again, copy that profile from this point to this point, but we wanna rotate it. We wanna rotate it 90 degrees like that. Okay, let's do a test. We wanna do a sweep one rail cross section here, and take a look and see if that work. Alright, so look like it depends on how wide you're, if you're gonna set the stone, you need to make sure it's wide enough for you to put the stone in there, and we want to move this up there and mirror to the other side. So right now it is good for us to take a look if everything working. As you can see, this bar is blocking in between those two, so it doesn't have any of the movement. So what we wanted to do is possibly we need to make this one a bit taller, and then maybe this one we need to give more room, so that's moving this one more like this way. Alright, so it's not touching the middle yet, so we still have a room on the side. We may want to move in a little bit. Okay, if the oval doesn't work because it's like too tapered down, maybe this is a good size, but we are going to change to the conic corner. So we're going to come in over here with the conic corner with the center. And then we want to snapping into here with the smart track. And then snapping over to this point and coming and snapping into this point as well. So it gives us where that corner is and coming in a little bit. As you can see, the new curve right here has more of a corner. So maybe that will be the line that we are going to use. Once we have set up everything, we can go ahead to delete all the surface, but keep the curve that we have there. And again, we can do more adjustment if we see if the curve is still blocking. All right, we want to make sure they are not touching. So now let's move the profile to the right place. We're going to use the move command to move this one to here and move this one to the quadrant as well. Now let's rebuild this surface. We're going to use a sweep one rail. This is a rail cross section, and that will be our link. This one we're going to build with the sweep one rail, and everybody is with the sweep one rail. So one more time, this one curve and go with this cross section, and I got that. All right, so now everybody is not touching, right? But now we are not changing anything on those parts, but we need to have an opening there, and you also need to go in down to the bottom there. So the way we are going to do is we want to move this one up. And how tall should we moving in? As long as it's not sticking with this link there, we should be fine. And we need to know like where we wanted to cut it. So I'm kind of need to, again, doing a test. I'm going to cut it somewhere about here. And to be symmetrical, I want to mirror that line to the other side. So now I have those two, it's going to trim off this one there. Now I need to have the one on the top mirror to the bottom. Okay, so if we are going to use create a surface, there are two ways to do it. We can use the blend tool. We're gonna blend from here to here, and let's take a look and see how well that is. And if that is too thick to you, you can kind of adjust the slide bar here to make it shorter. Alright, it look okay right here for me, but just need to be really careful if inside is deforming too much. Okay, so that is one way to do it. The other way, if inside is deforming too much, I'm going to show you another way, is we are going to blend. Instead of a surface, we want to blend the curve. So we're going to blend this curve to this curve, and it's going to give us a curve over there. And we can adjust the curve and then getting really close to where we want it. Okay, so once you get the curve you want, you click OK. And then we are going to use the command for sweep one. So this is going to be the rail, and this is going to be cross section here to here. Then we will get something like that. Notice that this is actually much more even surface. So I'm going to use that one, and we are going to mirror that to the other side. Don't forget to join those surface. And double make sure if they are closed, solid, poly surface. Okay, so now we have our structure. We just need to make sure that they are working fine. So let's go ahead to mirror that one to the other side. And we also want to mirror those guys to the other side right here. As you can see, it is blocking there, so maybe we need to adjust a little bit more. The easy way we can do is we can make this one a little bit wider, so we can moving all of this down a little bit. Let's delete this one and this one, and let's do another copy. Let's mirror that one to the other side, so now it's not touching. So this is the way that you adjust this. For the stone setting part, I have an online course to teach you a different kind of a stone setting for the model. And I also have a playlist on YouTube and have a few videos talking about stone setting. Please check them out. Don't forget to check out my new feature on the membership program. With your support, allow me to create more video and help more people to learn jewelry. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next.